Good morning to all. Today we are going to study the third chapter of the grammar, the correct uses of pronoun. All of you take your English grammar text for the class. Page number 20, third chapter, the correct uses of pronoun. A pronoun can be used as a subject, as an object, and in mode to express possession. Okay, a pronoun can be used as a subject and an object. And the word as express a possession. Okay, then rule for the uses of pronoun. First rule is mine, ours, yours, his, hers, and theirs are possessive pronoun. Which are the possessive pronoun? Mine, ours, yours, his, hers, and theirs. They are used in the place of noun, not with the nouns. They are used in the place of nouns. Okay, this book is mine. This is my book. This book is mine. That is the correct. Okay. Then rule 2. The following pronoun don't take the apostrophe. Here don't take the apostrophe. Okay. Yours, ours, hers, its, theirs. They are telling that here they are not right like our then apostrophe. That is wrong. Okay. Ours, O-U-R-S, that is right. Not that, it is. Its means it is. Yours sincerely. Yours, there is, wrong is yours, apostrophe, your apostrophe S is wrong. Okay. You can see that in the textbook. Yours sincerely, these ideas of ours, these ideas of our apostrophe S. Rule 3. Complement of the verb be, is, am, are, was, were, etc. is always in the subjective case. The complement of the verb be, that is, is, are, am, was, were, that all are always in the subjective case. Examples. Rule number 3. Their examples are, it was I who did it, not me. They are representing me as I there. Okay. It is we who told the truth, not as. In modern English, such case, such uses as hello, it's me, who's there, it's me, like that. In old English, hello, I'm, that example is hello, I'm Rajalakshmi, like that they will say. But in modern English, it is converted into hello, it's me, like that. Okay. And then rule 4, the object of the verb or a preposition should be in the objective case. Here, please let him go now, not he. Him means that's they're representing a male. Okay, so not he, him. Let her and me do it, not she or I. None but me was present there, not I, like that. Okay. Then reflective pronoun, myself. Reflective means myself, ourselves, yourselves, then yourself, himself, herself, itself, themselves, like that. They are used when the subject and object are same person. Okay. We helped ourselves. She has hurt herself. The child burned itself. That is, the A uses the subject and object are the same cases, then only the same persons, then only there, ourselves, yourselves, then ourselves, then yourselves, himself, herself, like that only they said. Okay. Rule 5. Reflective pronouns are never used as a subject. Reflective pronouns are never used as a subject. Yourself can do it. It easily. You can do it easily. Himself is to blame for it. He is to blame for it. Rule 6. Reflective pronouns are used after verb plus preposition. He spoke to himself. He spoke to himself. Then look after yourself. Did she play for herself? Okay, verb plus preposition. But the reflective form is not used when the preposition indicates the some place or a space. He took his dog with him, not himself. They put the child between them, not themselves.
Page number 22. These are the answers of first and second exercise. You should copy it and don't use pen. I am here writing, use this pen because of you didn't get what I am writing. So that way I use the red pen. Okay, don't use pen. You have to use a pen slowly. Then rule 7. The following pronoun always take a singular verb. Each of theirs, sorry, each of, either of, neither of, none of, no one, anyone, someone, etc. Either, neither is when usually when a choice is expressed between two nouns.
Rule 7, example, every none, any is used when a choice is expressed between more than two nouns. None of these girls is my cousins. He has 3 sons, each has a car. Then neither of the 2 boys was intelligent. There are 2 hotels, either or neither is good. Here, these all are used when a choice is expressed between more than 2 nouns. Then again, rule 8. When different personal pronouns are used together, their order should be second person, third person, first person, like that. You, he and I will go with the girls. Here, you is a second person, then he is third person, then I is the first person. When personal pronouns are used together, their order should be like that. Second person, then third person, then the first person. You, they and we have scored a big victory. Here you is a second person, they is the third person, then we is the first person there. Okay, but this order is reversed if there is a mention of full fault. First person, third person, second person. I, he and you are responsible for this loss. We, they and you will punish for it. Rule 9. When one is used as a pronoun, it should be used throughout. Then here is a one is used as a pronoun, it should be used as a throughout. They are using like the pronoun only. Okay. One must do one's duty, not his. One should see what one eats. Then rule 10. A pronoun must agree with its antecedent, that is the word to which it is refers back. All passengers showed their tickets. Every man must bear his own burden. Each of these girls showed her homeworks. Last one is rule 11. When the subject of the clause is relative pronoun, that, who, which, the verb should agree with the antecedent, that is the word to which the relative pronoun refers back. He is one of the boys who have been selected, not has, who have been selected, like that. This is the only one of his poem that was published, not where. In the sentence 1, the relative pronoun who refers back to boys. Therefore, the verb should be have, not has. Then the sentence 2, the relative pronoun that refers to the only one. Therefore, the verb should be was, not were. Students, these are the homework. You have to done this homework, page number 24. And the first one is rewrite each sentence correctly. Also mention the rule you have used for your correction. Second one is choose the correct word from the bracket. These are the 2 homeworks. We will discuss the answers of these homeworks in the next class. Thank you, children.